So what's growth hacking? It's nothing new, nothing at all new. It's just using all of that that is already available in a way that's going to work well for your startup. Growth hacking is just about finding the most relevant marketing hack that's going to work exclusively for your startup. You know, you could do anything. You're doing SEO, you're doing social media, you're doing press releases, you know, all of that you can do. But what is the one thing that's going to take you from zero to some level? That's what growth hacking is all about. It's just a term coined by Sean Elish, I think, in 2010. It's nothing new. So there are different tools, and the only thing you should be concerned about, which tool is for me, how do I use it, and how do I keep getting better using it?
Right. Before we proceed, let's just put it, you know, more of our context, so that we'll appreciate, you know, what we're going to learn today. So if you simply, as we have learned from Shivankit, growth hacking is a way where we just want to take our traction from say few users to say a million. Okay. And say assume you go to internet and you type this word growth hacking, you'll get a lot of articles. 28 ways of growth hacking, in fact 101 ways of growth hacking. So if we just read them, if we apply them, is it going to take us from say few users to 1 million? No. Why not? There are a couple of, you know, there are basically two problems with growth hacking techniques. First, they come up with an expiry date. So there is a growth hack which has been used by people and it has been there, very popular for 2 years. It's no more effective now. It has to be something new. Second thing is that growth hacks have to be specific. You cannot apply a generic growth hack and you can expect that you'll grow to a million users in 6 months because you're doing something, you know, which is done by others. So that's why